As far as how the movie came about, it came about with sheer woman power. Not saying that the producers, because, you know, thank you to Forest Whitaker. Thank you to Pharrell Williams. Thank you for seeing the vision. Thank you for knowing that this was going to be something, or feeling that the story was definitely worth the check. Like, thank you for that. But this was definitely women driven. This was a sisters project. And being a sisters project, I mean, Nina Bon Jovi and Mimi Valdez, from the moment we met, I knew it was just something magical. I knew that this was going to happen. I knew this was going to be something great. I knew that this was going to take place. And when we went to Sundance, and I remember, and I don't think I've said this in an interview, but I remember being in Sundance and sitting in the car, and it was a blizzard outside. And I was like, oh, this weather is crazy. I don't think anybody's going to come out to this, because it's just, you know, we're in Utah. And I didn't know that, you know, I knew that it snows a lot in Utah because we've been there before. But, you know, to get 5 feet of snow every night, and it looks like the next morning they just clear the roads, and then 5 feet of snow every night. And this is our third night here in Utah, and now it's my turn to premiere. And I was saying to myself, like, wow, this is, I don't know. So when we turned the corner and I saw people lined up down the block in a blizzard, with signs that said, please, can I just get 2 tickets to see Roxanne, Roxanne? I knew that this was going to be something amazing. I knew that there was something more to this story than what I even thought, you know? And I must say, I was hyped as hell. I was like, oh, they want 2 tickets. Do we have tickets in the car? And they was like, no, all the tickets are gone. We hardly have seats for you guys. And I was like, you hardly have seats for us. And that was going to be my first time seeing the movie, because I didn't see the movie beforehand. And even though I served as EP and I was on set every day, you know, people were like, well, you know, if you served as executive producer, why didn't you watch the movie? One of the things I did was I wanted to make sure that each scene was organic. So I wanted to make sure it was as close to what originally, and it did. It turned out it's absolutely true. I didn't want people to think that this was made up or that was made up. So what I did was we started taking, after the movie was on Netflix, what we started doing was taking the original interviews and things from 30 years ago and playing them so people could do the timetable themselves and truly enjoy the movie, because you enjoy more so what you know is real than what you know is not. So to see, you know, me and Molly 30 years ago, and then to see us on screen now and see that it's the same exact conversation, you know, makes them say, wow, you know, this Roxanne Shanté shit is real. and I take a lot of pride in that. And so that was my experience with the movie, as far as even my first time seeing it. You know, when some things are God's plan, when some things are destined, when some things are actually created by the universe, they're not difficult. And there was not a difficult moment on, there wasn't a difficult moment on set. We filmed in Queensbridge Projects. We filmed in the projects 28 days, taking over all of the parking in the largest housing project in the world. And never once did we have a complaint. Never once did we have somebody walk through the set like, yo, I'm walking through the set. That none of the problems. Like, we had heard a lot from a lot of other movies, and they were saying like, oh, if you're gonna film there, it's gonna be hard. You can't control the people. And the thing about it is that my love and respect for my hood showed even in how much love and respect my hood has for me. And because of that, we had not one problem, not one trailer incident, nothing. So it went smoothly. Everything went smoothly. And I could not have asked for a better cast, a better crew, even a better film crew. And that's because when you do things when they're supposed to happen, that's when they work out right. But when you force things, you know, you just can't force them. You know, the same way with how I made my first record on my way to the laundromat. I didn't force it. I stopped. I did it, went downstairs and did the laundry. Who's to say what would have been the difference if I would have tried to write it down and took the time and tried to go to a radio station trying to get a record deal? Like, I didn't do any of that. You know, the Roxanne Shanté things, this is just the balance of the universe. People think, and also from the movie, I wanted people to understand that even in your younger life, when things can be very difficult for you, it doesn't mean they're always going to be difficult. That some of your most successful people, some of your more happy adults had horrible childhoods or had difficult childhoods, or we've all been through something. So if you're able to just say, okay, you know what, this is temporary, and after the bad comes good. And, you know, and then understand that even sometimes after the good comes bad, but then the good comes again. then you just, you master this thing in life. You know, you'll be like me. You'll be, you know, damn near 50 years old, enjoying life, eating candy, you know, all that good stuff. You'll be able to do all of those things because you understand what your purpose is and how it's supposed to be. You know, watching the movie, I did not have a surreal moment or one of those moments where I was like, oh, look, we've done it, or look, it has happened. I didn't have that. I had that the moment that the car turned the corner and I saw the line in the blizzard. That's when I had that. After that, everything else was like, we got this. Everything else was, I know we're good. Like, at the first, I know one thing that for sure, that when I did walk into the theater building, the first thing that I did look for was Mimi and Nina. Like, I looked for them. I looked beyond Pharrell, beyond Forrest, even beyond my husband and beyond my son, you know, and beyond my daughter. I looked specifically for them because I needed to have that eye-catching moment with them in order to say, like, look, you know. And I think what we did was we gave each other just that smile, and then we sat all different seats because people had already crowded in the theater, so nobody sat together. And that's what we did. When people ask me about the Nas scene in the movie, that wasn't my story. Actually, Nas had told it first in Illmatic, because I'm a person who doesn't say, oh, I did this for this person, I did that, I'm responsible for this, responsible for that, because that's not how you get your blessings. When you tell what you did for somebody, then it's scrapped out, you know, and you can't do that. You can't, you know, if that's how you, that's not how things work. If you want it to be properly done, you do it from the heart. So with Nas, even though I had threatened him and did all that when I was younger, I was so proud of what Nas has become. I am so proud of the man who he is that I felt I would tarnish that by telling it. And then he told it first, which allowed us to put it organically in the movie. But had he not told it first, I probably would have never said a word.